Shop Talk, baby. This is the show where it's okay to be you. We're talking from Yale to jail and from the church house to the pimp house. Nothing's excluded on Shop Talk. So if you don't have a phone, I suggest you borrow one. Call in and voice your opinion live every Saturday morning from 10 a.m. to 12 noon. Yeah, that's right, 10 a.m. to 12 noon. Don't forget to Shop Talk with your girl, because right here, oh, we keeps it real.
Y'all know about that, Rick James.
Hey, it's cold-blooded.
You crazy. It's all good. All right. Let's go and do what it is that we do. Hello.
Hi.
We got R in the building.
R in the building.
We got M in the building.
Well, you now
don't do that. And now we got T in the building.
T is the only one that makes sense.
RMT, that sounds like it was an LSG.
LSG, that's all the singer group. Y'all ready? What'd you say, T, the only one that makes sense?
The only thing that makes sense.
M. What's up, M?
Well, my last name started with a C, so that's cool.
That's cool. MC?
There you go.
Oh, okay.
RS?
Yeah, no.
RS sound like, I told you it sounded like some type of diagnosis.
Respiratory.
But like, crazy. What the heck is going on? All right, let's get started with these hot topics. But before we do the hot topics, I want to introduce the panel today. Right. Y'all know Roogle in the building. Can you say something? That's it?
Yeah.
Do you need some help?
What's
like
today?
Some cheers?
Today's
something?
What? The 20 what? The 26th, 7th, right?
28.
We got a bonus day of Black History.
Bonus.
Make the most of it.
Yeah, you got
Make
that.
The most of it.
We got that. All right, and then we got Mike in the building. Right. Want to say what's up to Mike?
Hey. That's about it.
That's all we get.
Till I get started.
That's it?
That's it.
Till you get started?
Till I get started.
Then we got T in the building.
The only name that makes sense.
He like, hey, how y'all doing? So good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever it is, we gonna make it happen. All right, let's get started with these hot topics real quick, okay? Deion Cole. You know who Deion Cole is?
Yes. He's from the show I put in my decade, one of the best shows of the decade. Blackish.
Yeah, that's your favorite show.
Yeah, it is. I like All it
right.
Lot.
Do you know?
Yeah, actually, Deion Cole was only supposed to write for Blackish.
Okay.
But he done such a great job that they actually casted him to be the person that he was writing for. That's how he actually got.
I thought that he should have been casted anyway. Yeah, Do you know Deion Cole?
Yeah, he plays Charlie on the show.
All right. Well, Deion Cole, he's a comedian first. Mm-hmm. That's what I know. Yeah. Anyway, he kind of is hitting the internet, going viral because of his outfit that he wore to the NAACP. Now, we all saw the outfit, right? The black velvet.
Was that black or blue?
Black.
Look, midnight.
Midnight. See, there you go, trying to start something else. Midnight. No, look, it ain't even midnight. See, now you got to say midnight.
Midnight blue.
The black velvet bell-bottom outfit. Now, what's interesting is that a lot of people were saying, social media, they like, he gay. Why is gay such a thing now? Like, what's happening? Like, they turn it into like a negative notation.
I think the thing is that it's still a very taboo situation in the black community.
So just because he wore some bell bottoms,
I ain't saying he should have been called that, but I'm saying that's what people they react to that. They try to separate.
He said he got death threats.
Now, that's a little bit ridiculous. They wanted to kill him because of the outfit killed himself because it was just horrible. You ain't have to kill him. The camera did that when it took his picture.
You ain't like the outfit you wouldn't wear?
I wouldn't. I look like Elvis up in that belly hanging out over the crushed velvet. Looking nuts.
That's what did it, the crushed velvet, too. But velvet is back. So what's your thoughts?
My thought is, when you got money like that, you got a stylist. You got a person that's going to dress you or put your clothes on you or give you your clothes.
Okay.
That person should be the first person to say, that ain't cutting it.
The stylist is probably who actually dressed them. Right. So the stylist should be fired?
But you know what? He a comedian, so he's making a statement. Does it make sense to me? I'm not that man, so I don't know.
You know what? If it would have been like, if the color of it would have been like, let's say, green, pink, or something lavender, like a bright color, then you can say, okay, he's a comedian. But that was like made to be formal.
Yes, it was.
You know,
it was
like he was trying to impress, I think. But
all right, what's your thoughts, T?
How old is he, first of all?
He was like 45.
No,
for the outfit.
No way, shape, or form.
Okay,
I thought it was ugly.
You thought it was ugly?
And if my stylist would have did that to me, I'd fire him.
Fire the stylist. Hey, it was a Gucci outfit. You know, people, they like labels.
Well, they banned the Gucci for a little while.
Gone.
They did. Actually, nobody was wearing Gucci. Nobody wanted to talk about Gucci after some sad story came out. But it was just horrible.
Now tell me this. But Prince could wear it.
But Prince was Prince was different. Prince was androgynous. Prince can wear pretty much anything he wanted to.
Yeah, but I just watched Purple Rain the other day, and it still hold up.
Yeah. It still hold up.
And I just, you know, what Prince can do, everybody else can do.
But it started from somewhere.
The bell bottoms, they've been around for forever.
But even like his clothes, all right, here you go. Usually people, they'll come out, you got the comedians. Like we said, he was a comedian. Everybody remembers the red leather pantsuit.
Eddie Murphy.
Mm-hmm. What was wrong with that? Because they talked about that.
There's a lot wrong with it.
What? What you think?
You talking about the Delirious outfit? Yes. Or the Raw.
Raw. Eddie Murphy Raw.
What did he have in Delirious? Did he have a red outfit on there?
I don't know. That might be his thing.
Either
way.
You thought something was wrong because it was red?
It's just too. You can't be a grown man walking around in leather pants, man. It's just too much heat.
Hey, if you think about it.
He got a gang of kids, so it ain't hurt nothing. The heat didn't hurt nothing.
I think it was the very first Beverly Hills Cop when Eddie Murphy was walking down the street and somebody had that same outfit on. And he laughed at it.
Yeah.
He looked at it, then he turned around and he laughed at it.
It was Beverly Hills Cop.
Was after his stand-up. So because people were talking about his outfit, because what you said, it was different people that wasn't feeling his red leather outfit. However, it made me say, I need me some red leather pants in my closet.
But it was a different time. Yeah. It was a different time.
You know why? Because here's the difference. The only time, say I know you, mm-hmm. and you wore it, all you had to do was hear me say, man, that's whack. That's all you had to hear, because social media wasn't out. But if social media was out back then, they probably would have ate them up.
But we're talking about the 80s, though. At the 80s, it was like everybody was wearing, you could wear leather pants in the 80s. You could.
I don't remember seeing no dude in no red leather pants in the 80s. Help me out. Was that out? It was just him.
No, he wasn't alone.
Who else? Rick James?
Yeah. I mean, I think that was like the leather outfit was to symbolize a rock star status.
Okay. I'm with you on that. I can say that.
Well, Michael Jackson wore leather everything.
Michael Jackson?
He had the leather coat. Remember, you used to count the zippers if it was
leather.
That was a leather jacket.
But his pants was kind of...
He had regular pants, regular black pants.
Yeah.
Look, regular old black pants. I'm saying regular black.
I mean, Thriller, he had on red jeans or something.
Yeah, but they was jeans.
Yeah.
Beat It, those were red leather pants. And Beat It.
I don't think he had on.
Man,
no,
you got to do.
No, I can show you the Michael Jackson.
This is what we gonna do because we got a show to do. Y'all can look that up later.
And see
what he had. But the only person I think that had the leather pants was Eddie Murphy, and it was people that was talking about it. But it seemed like the woman was okay with his red leather. Help me out.
Back then, yeah,
it was acceptable. You can do it.
An issue, like you said, there was no social media back then.
Yeah, it was just like your grandmother or your auntie be like, you should be ashamed of yourself. Mm-hmm. And then that was it. You only just had to hear about the people in your circle. It was just
a conversation, you know, when somebody said, that, you know.
Or they call on the phone. You see his outfit? He about to look like a fool up there on that stage. And don't nobody know, Carly. Yeah, he about to go on stage looking like a fool. Look at them. He up. They yelling up. Look at them screaming. Like, you know how that is. Now on social media, they eating you up. Now, what do you feel? How do you feel about him getting death threats?
That's taking it too far. You can't give it. First of all, there's nothing that any entertainer. Well, let me stop. But let me say this: he should not get death threats because of what he chooses to wear. I could see if he had a shirt that had some kind of craziness written on it or something. He just made a bad fashion choice. That's all.
His stylist. Yeah, what you say? That's horrible. Somebody need to be fired, okay? So we all in agreement on that one. Now I want to talk about Gail, since we talk about death threats. But you always get that one, and not justifying it, but you always get that one strange person that might need some attention that's going to do a death threat. And you don't even know the people, so who cares? Like, they ain't got nothing to do. Probably sitting there, got crates in their house, one beat-up couch, and trolling everybody's social media, and everybody caring about this individual. Like, that's crazy to me.
The computer on the milk crate, and they just linked over.
Yeah, they're like, I got to get in there. Like, just what? Just trolling. So how do you feel about with Gail's situation? I know everybody knows about what she said, and then Snoop Dogg calling her out. Her name, and he was on the Red Table Talk with Jada Pinkett, and they said that Jada put him in his place. No, she didn't. She just pretty much was saying, you calling a black woman a B was pretty much like calling all of us Bs. So, and yes, he apologized already. Matter of fact, he apologized twice. Y'all know Snoop is my guy. My thing is, she never apologized to Kobe's family. Do you think that she should have?
She should have.
I don't think she should
have. You don't think that she should have?
That should have never come up, you know.
I was watching The Daily Show, and they have a person on there named Duce Sloan, I think her name is. Anyway, so she was talking about Reverend King. And in there, she talked about all this stuff like that he did. And then she also said that he had a history of being a womanizer. And things said, hey, should you be saying that or whatever? And she's like, yes, because we have to understand that our heroes are not perfect. They are people.
Okay, that sound all well and good, but let's talk about this. She ain't said nothing about Harvey Weinstein.
Well, Harvey Weinstein ain't being honored by nobody.
No, but that ain't what I'm saying. Kobe, come on now. He passed away. I think it was just too soon, and to focus on that little clip, and the network actually did that, and they just put it out there, and I guess just for advertisement, but that was like the wrong thing to do. Like we talked about on the show last week, the one white chick, she said, and it was like, she got suspended, and then I guess, okay, well, since I'm black, I can go ahead and say it. Now, a lot of people are sitting there having an issue with Gail and Oprah, because here's the deal. She didn't do, Oprah talked about Russell Simmons and his issue, talked about Michael Jackson had those guys on there. That's somebody that died, and see, that's the difference. Kobe died, and then they're not saying anything about, they couldn't defend themselves, but now you're not talking about the people that's living. Now, Harvey Weinstein, why? Because his status, like, why? Because you know the butler, he's the one, her and him, they did that together.
Her
Oprah and him.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Which was a good movie, by the way.
Yeah. Well, I think the thing with him is that, like, again.
And we know he's guilty.
No one's celebrating him. No, you know what
so
I mean?
So you feel as though nobody really knows him?
No, people know who he is.
Now from the Me Too movement, because I know who he was.
Well, people who was in the know, of Hollywood knew
the big
Weinstein.
People. Us little people. No,
I mean.
Look, me, I'm the little people that didn't really know who he was.
All you had to do was don't look at just who's starring in the movie, but look at who's producing the movie. What company is producing it?
I forget. You're the movie guy, so you're looking
you
at
see
the credits.
All that stuff, like,
I ain't looking at the credits.
But the thing is that They are talking about the event, an event that happened to him. I don't really remember what the question was. Could it have been inappropriate to ask the question? Maybe. Is it a question that was did the question have any legitimacy to the person they was asking it to? I don't really think so.
He wasn't found guilty.
Yeah.
Why are we talking about this?
He settled. There was a settlement.
Well, he wasn't guilty.
He wasn't guilty.
So I'm going with that.
But he did admit that he had consensual sex with the lady.
Okay, so something wrong with that?
No.
Okay, go ahead.
I mean, well, yeah, he was married.
Well, I guess morally. But hey, she got a nice ring. Go ahead.
I mean, y'all probably can go back and forth.
Y'all, what's your thoughts?
But I really don't worry about stuff that I don't care about. I heard you say that Snoop apologized to somebody for calling somebody out their name.
Well, he apologized for Gail King. Do you know who Gail King
is? Yeah, that's Oprah's homegirl.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, so you like, I don't even know, apologize to somebody to somebody. Well, we go, okay, Mike.
Gotcha.
Let's go to T.
Yeah, go on to T. Because I'm telling you, because a lot of people get upset about, okay, Snoop Dogg apologized because all his lyrics have the word B in there. All right, great.
He apologized because his mother told him to apologize. Right, go ahead.
But once again, I say it like this. Tupac was one of the smartest rappers on the planet. He made Dear Mama. He made Brennan's Had a Baby. Then he also made a song for C. Dolores Tucker called You Wonder Why We Call Him B.
Uh-huh.
All right. He had a
That was the answer right there.
Now, I'm not calling all women Bs.
Uh-huh.
But if you wonder why we call some of them this, this is the reason.
Get Tupac's.
But the rest of it, we're going to go on ahead over here because I don't pay attention to that.
So what do you think we're talking about with Gail, and we talked about how, you know, most people felt that it was too soon and felt that he couldn't defend himself, and she was asking Leslie, you know, about that particular situation.
I don't think she should have did that, period.
Okay.
You know, especially with, you know, him passing away, and then it was so tragic.
Mm-hmm.
And you know how messed up the rest of his family was. And then to hear that, she could have asked any other question and it probably would have been fine. That one, she shouldn't have touched that. As far as Snoop,
him going off on her, he was mad. Yeah. Speaking of emotions,
that was his boy, and I get that, but he probably should have approached it a different manner. You know, maybe I need to cool off first and then talk to her.
Okay. Do you think that he should have talked to her privately or with social media? Social media, everybody just going live. People getting killed. Just going.
I think he should have did it
privately.
Because social media, people take things and just turn it the way that they want it to be,
mm-hmm.
regardless of what's going on. So.
And we know the world is judgmental, so everybody's going to have something to say.
Yeah,
go ahead. What's your thoughts?
I just think that, like, it just amazes me how people who have real power don't use it the right way. Because all Snoop had to do was say, we need to boycott King. Don't have anybody interview with her. If she's going to ask inappropriate questions, nobody interview with
her. It's funny that you should say that. He didn't say that, but in my mind, that's what I need that silent night. I heard in my mind, the Christmas song, Silent Night. In my mind, I was thinking just from her doing that, that I believe that this like is probably be like a private one, and he didn't have to say that, because why would you even go? It's like you and you know they feeling some type of way with Oprah too, so that could be her girl all day long, but they feel like they're not interviewing with them anymore. You know what I mean? And then you see different people, and they might have some type of side of thing like, I'm not doing that because you're gonna be bringing up this part of it, but I'm still stuck on. Even though you said that there was a settlement, yes, there was a settlement, but guess what? If you're not there and I don't have a record behind her, why would you bring that up? It doesn't exist.
Yeah, I mean, and the thing is like...
And then the people, and not to cut you off, even though you have to do the legwork to see what happened in the past, but you figure that was over 20 years ago, so there was a lot of young people that had no idea that she brought it, like, what? They didn't even know. You just old. But just looking at the young
it
people...
It wasn't 20 years ago either.
Though. That was. No. Yes, it was. Okay, look it up real quick. Do some legwork.
It was like 2003.
What year is it now?
It's 2020. That's not...
It's almost...
Okay.
Almost 20 years.
We rounding up.
Okay, yeah, we rounding. That's what we doing, so... And you figured they probably... Like,
round down on my birthday.
Round down on your birthday. Go down. Yeah. Well, that's what we'll do. We'll do that. All right, Harvey Weinstein. Y'all know that he complained of chest pain. He went to jail, and then they sent him on out to the hospital with that walker. You know how fast he was walking with that walker? I was like, he might as well just throw that thing over his shoulder. He was like, boom. I'm like, about to trip over the doggone walker, walking so doggone fast. So he had chest pain, and it's a meme going around where there's
Him and Bill Cosby
feeding him pudding.
Yeah.
Jello. How you feel? I think that was going to like 16 years for him.
They ain't sentencing yet, did they? I don't know. Okay. But he's facing a gang of time.
Coming up in March. I think in the next couple of weeks.
I got something to confess.
You got a walker?
No. I do got a walker. But I watched the first season of The Cosby Show.
And you got a confession?
It was great.
It was great. It got a confession. No, I listened to R. Kelly 12 play.
Oh, I wouldn't do that now. It's like you got a limit to what I would do. But yeah, I was watching that. I was watching that.
The first season.
Mm-hmm. And it's like, they wrote that first season like they wasn't coming back for any other season.
You gotta go hard.
It was amazing.
Okay.
Like, all the great stuff about The Cosby Show that you remember was in there.
Okay, now here's the thing. So, did it tarnish you? You're looking at him right now because he offered that lady some tea or some Quaaludes, and she was like, I take cup B.
Okay, this is what I noticed when I watched it.
Go ahead.
There's a lot of sex in The Cosby Show. Him and Claire is getting it on all the time.
Okay.
All the time.
Okay.
And then there's a couple other things. I know, I was like,
well, so you look at it differently.
I looked at it differently, but it was kind of sex in a way that you could get a, you know.
So why did you look, I know you've seen it before. So
well, before, because you just thought, this is a husband and wife, and this is how it's supposed to be.
Absolutely. So now they done tarnished his little history. Large history. And now you're looking at it like it's a lot of sex, and come on, man. What's your thoughts about that? Can you separate the art from the artist?
Listen, I'm going to tell it to you like this. I still watch The Cosby Show. It come on Prime.
I watched it on.
When Bill tried to explain to his dad why he got D's, it seemed like such a,
and he was dyslexic.
A great moment. Yes. He was like, you know, you shouldn't get mad at me. You know, you're a doctor. Mom's a lawyer. You should just love me for who I am. And Bill Cosby said, Theo, he said, yeah, Dad. He said, that was the dumbest thing ever said. I see why you get D's all the time. Now, see, this is the thing. What Bill Cosby done offset, you know, was bad. But what he did on set, he was everybody's dad. He was America's pop. And now, I can't just go back and stop. Now, I know he probably left there, went to do what he wasn't supposed to be doing. Mm-hmm. But from season one through forever.
It's like eight seasons.
Yeah, it was.
I only watched the first one.
Okay, you know, hold on.
I got them all.
Okay, yeah. Go ahead. What's your thoughts?
I don't think what he did was bad because she went to his house.
Okay.
Okay.
Deal.
And how are you going to take some pills from somebody that you don't really know?
Yeah, no idea who they are.
See, we think the same because I thought the same thing. I'm like, when you went over there, you kind of knew what was going on. And you knew he had a wife. Did you think that she was living?
She had been back there before. So
you going like 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. Somebody offer you some Anacin. You're going to go ahead and take it.
Anacin?
Yeah, you remember that. That's like
the oldest of old people. Is it aspirin?
Wait, let me throw back.
So, and you're going to go ahead and take it at what? 2, 3 o'clock in the morning? Yeah.
But you remember that whole thing with Mike Tyson? Remember that whole thing years
Tupac,
ago?
Yeah, same thing.
Same thing.
Yeah. Why are you? My daughter's here.
Uh-huh.
She's here right now. She's right behind
me. Okay, we don't want to tell nobody that because then they can be coming to give me children's services.
Here's the thing. Now, I love my child to death. I love her to death. But there is only a few things open after a certain amount of time, at a certain day, at a certain time. For 3 o'clock, if some man calls you at 3 o'clock in the morning, and you think you're just going over there to watch.
I'm having some tea. Yeah,
right. Absolutely. He just called me over because he wanted some Sanka.
Okay.
Yeah, no. Understand where you at. Understand your worth. Understand what's going on. You know you in the presence of a celebrity. You already know that it's in and out type of situation. And then 100 years later, you say, this is what happened to me.
Listen, how about that grandma? That grandma done sat there and told the world she should have took that on to her grave. She done told the world that she done bought for apples. with Bill Cosby. Grandma. I'd be like, Gramps, did you, like, you should have left that. She like 70-something.
Yeah, but you act like she was that age when she was doing it or something.
My point is, why bring it up? Let it go. The only one that could go down in history for bombing for apples is Monica Lewinsky.
True.
That's it.
Listen, I just brought up the show to talk about a few things. In that show, there was a couple things that sort of like, for example, I believe the person who wrote John Wick got their inspiration from The Cosby Show.
Probably a lot of people there, that wrote a whole lot of things probably got a lot of inspiration
There's a movie that Theo goes to see that Vanessa wants to go see, but she can't see it because of all the gun violence or whatever, blah, blah, blah. And they come back and they talk about it. And the punchline was, well, why did he do all this? Because someone has stole his car.
And you think, oh,
John Wick. About the zombies. She wanted to go see the movie about the zombies with her brother.
And see, yeah. you got them in your bag. Yeah,
and then he came home and told her about the movie. And then she couldn't sleep, so she had to go into their room and sleep. And like, wow.
Oh, look, see, Mike just seen it. He already knows. So you can separate the art from the artist.
I can. I mean, it is what it is. You, until everybody found out all of that or whatever, then they started taking all the shows off of this and taking all the shows off of that. But a lot of people still had their DVDs.
Okay, now, like, I like Michael Jackson. Y'all see, I got my off the wall on the wall. Mm-hmm. Now, can you separate the art from the artist?
I still listen to him.
Now, Michael Jackson gone down, and then now you got some of the people that said that he molested them, saying that it was a lie. Mm-hmm. You done killed the man, and then they still have it, just like when Oprah did that show with those other guys saying he did molest them, but he wasn't here to defend himself. Mm-hmm. So it's like, now they're like, oh yeah, well, he's a molester, a pedophile. Like, come on.
I got another confession. My favorite Michael Jackson song is PYT.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Right. But I actually was listening to it. He says, pretty young thing. Now repeat after me. Nah, 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 nah.
Nah, 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 nah.
He said he meant trying to make people think no is yes.
You think that that's what it was?
I don't know.
Look at him start something. You think that's what it was? No means yes?
No means nah, 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 nah.
Look at him.
I don't know. But I love, that's my favorite song. But I thought about it. I was like, pretty young thing. Even though you could say, you could...
But you have a lot of writers too that may be right for him. Just
who
like
wrote that song?
Now,
was that a Quincy Jones written song?
Yeah, I don't even know who it was. I ain't even got time to even look it up. But here, now you're talking about Michael Jackson and what he wrote. Now you had different people. I was talking to some other guys where back to the R. Kelly. He don't like R. Kelly. Let me talk about it. With the R. Kelly situation, they were saying it's people that social media and everything that he's dealing with right now. They can't listen to his music because they said now that they listen to the music, like mm-hmm. Your Body's Calling, they have an image of a little girl. Mm-hmm. So is that accurate?
Yeah.
From a male's perspective, I just want to know.
Let me tell you something. Listen to me. That Get Up on the Room is still an amazing song for me.
Is it? And you just look at it as music.
I just look at it as, he said, man, it's getting hot in his car.
Okay.
You know, why are we sitting here? I don't get that deep into it. I know, and you know, he's already dealing with his issues. He's already getting punished for what he's doing. But you know, just like Deion Cole said in Barbershop, you know, we missing out on a lot of good R. Kelly music because of this nonsense is going on. He can everything that he had before this situation is still his heart, but he can't make nothing after this. I mean, he's done.
You think so?
What is he going to sing about? He can't sing about anything without somebody putting a microscope on top of it and saying that this
and tearing
is
it apart.
Right. So he can't make that new
one. I mean, it's always gospel. He can hold.
He
his
did.
Own
I feet. Believe I can fly.
Yeah.
Fly.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean,
yeah, but you know what? Most of his songs that he made that
didn't they be talking about? I know Sunday school.
Right.
See?
Hey, and I ain't gonna, that took the that was the song that really tied the secular into was it secular is mm-hmm. Christian into like mainstream music. That was
wait, secular is what he sings. Real, that's gospel music.
Okay, however,
the opposite.
Reverse that. Yeah, but that was a great song. But
is it still a great song?
Yeah.
Or is it okay?
I mean, it's still a great song. It's like one of those things where you find out like somebody owns slaves, like you know, like for example, like people talk about Thomas Jefferson, like Thomas Jefferson is the father of this country. He wrote the Constitution, and he's like, yeah, but he owns slaves. He's like, ah.
And you're feeling some type of way.
Yeah, I mean, because it's like one of the, like, it's just like one of those terrible things that, like, you know, it comes back and it's like, man, but you said this, but you did that.
Now, that's funny that you should say that since it is Black History Month. We could touch on that a little bit. So you have a problem with people who own slaves when... And that's what it sounds like. No, I just really have to say that because I want to talk on black crime and how... We actually pull each other down. And like this situation, well, we ain't talking about R. Kelly and stuff like that, but even like with Gail, You know, and it's like, okay, and it's almost like they try to say, and I say it black on black crime because it seems like, okay, well, a black person, we tearing down another black person, but she tore down, you know, a black person. And do we do that often? And you brought up the whole slave thing. And like I was saying on the show last week, I was like, it was us that got us over there.
That
over
wasn't
here.
The whole thing.
Well, let's just talk about the bit of it. They know white person went to doggone Africa and said, hey, why don't you come with me? It was some black people that said, okay, because you got to remember, if they kept, they had them as prisoners. Now, y'all know, I'm reading it. They had them as prisoners and traded them over to over here to be slaves for salt and sugar and pearls and jewelry. So let's come on now.
But that wasn't just all of it. That was some of it.
That's important. No, but listen, you and you, black men, y'all got a better chance. We all in the presence of each other of saying, hey, Mel, why don't you come with us to this party? Let's come with us to this cruise. And I'm like, all of my boys. Okay, I'm going to get on the cruise. I know y'all going to go over there and just trade me in for some doggone jewelry or some salt.
Well, I'll tell you this. You know,
but I'm more apt to go with you versus some white man to come and be like, hey, okay. Hey, Mel. Hey, want to go on the cruise? Nah. You know, who else going? Nah, I want to know. Is my peeps going or not?
But I think that simplifies a lot of what has happened. That may have been some of it, but that doesn't...
That's some of it that a lot of us that we need to...
Of it, though.
It don't have to be the whole of it, but we need to understand that it's us, too. It's us, too. We cannot sit there and eliminate ourselves. It was some shady people.
It's shady people, yeah, but I mean, but I don't think that we should, especially when you start talking about triangle slave trade, I really don't think that it was just like, hey, let's just give these people away for goods. I think it was more
than
that.
Well, when you capture them and you have prisoners and you sit and have them as prisoners, like, oh, okay, well, here's this person. This was before our time. I need y'all to read it and research it. And then you'll know what we're talking about. But let's be real. But even if it was probably a friend is who's going to talk you into it. If we do it that way, make it more simpler. A friend is going to talk you into smoking. A friend is going to talk you into drinking. Let's take it down.
Okay, but we got to be careful before we start saying the reason slaves...
I did not say the reason. Well, I'm saying that's part of it.
Well, you're trying to make it sound like it was peer pressure.
Not that part being peer pressure. But what I'm saying is, it's usually people that you know and you trust, and you say, okay, I'm going. Now, we bring it back to 2020. Let's be realistic. There's no white person that's going to be able to tell me, listen, I had my grandmother rest her in peace, okay? We was out at Staples. Let me tell
the,
you.
The store.
Okay. Not C Staples. C Staples should have been all right. She fell asleep in the car. And we were out there in the predominantly white neighborhood. Now, in the black neighborhood, she was in the car asleep. Also, good night, good rest. When she woke up and saw who he was in this predominantly white, let me tell you, she gave it to me. I said, what? She was like, you don't leave me in no car around all these white folks. Listen, totally. And I was like, huh? And in our mind, you know, stereotypically, is that a word?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, that passes. You sit there and you're like, okay, this is a good neighborhood. You'll be okay. Well, I'm about to take you down by the projects. I better say, hey, I'll be back. You know what I mean? Wake you up. She said, I'm more safer over there than I am out here. I don't know. And she was a lot older. So.
Wait,
and that was her truth.
What time of year was it?
Summer.
You left your grandmother in the car.
Air conditioner.
Summertime.
She
let the window roll down.
Grandma
was probably trying to break the window. They was like.
Trying to save her.
They left her grandmother in the car in the summertime.
Now y'all coming to give me lessons. She know how to walk and everything, but she felt like, don't leave me sleep in this car. I feel more safer in the hood versus more safe.
Yeah.
In the hood versus safer. In a predominantly white neighborhood. So again, just like her, the same way somebody white come to me, I'm like, hold on, I'm suspect. I'm checking. A cruise what? It's a free cruise? Who?
You know, you know, they came to the shore with they like bags packed or something like
hey,
that.
Hey, I'm giving you a visual.
Nobody,
I'm a screenwriter.
What are you talking about, man?
Hey, it's a cruise. Let's go.
No.
Hey, let it go. But black on black crime, do you think that we tear each other down?
I think that an unfair system in this country causes people to have to fend for themselves in ways that they get what they need from people that are around them. If and sometimes, unfortunately, that's by force.
Okay, what's your thoughts?
Black on black crime. Now, let me see. My thoughts is this. Now, we were talking about the racism thing.
Mm-hmm.
Like my grandmother used to tell me all the time, you have white people who don't like black people, then you have black people who don't like black people. So, you got black people who don't like white people, and then black people who don't like black people. Small story. Without the black on black crime part. I had a friend, love him to death. His mother couldn't stand white folks. Couldn't stand them. Hated them. The story is hilarious. First of all, she sent him to Cheney.
Okay.
All right. At that time.
That's a predominant for those white, who are listening, because we listen a lot. Since the show is worldwide.
Predominantly white school.
Okay.
All right. So, but I'm talking about it was like an undying hate for white people. Her undying hate for white people. My friend ended up getting married to a white woman.
Okay.
All right. So when he brung her home to visit his mom, he called me and he was like, I'm about to take my wife to visit my mom. I said, I gotta come.
Okay.
I gotta
see the response, right?
I gotta see what's going on. The response that he got from his mom was is something that I think wouldn't go happen. She embraced her because of the fact that she loved her son. What I would say about the black on black crime.
The reason I'm saying black on black crime because that's just like a slogan that we do and we tear, do you think that we tear each other down?
I believe so. I honestly believe so because I think somebody, you know, even with the kids, you don't have the latest this or the latest that. You're not here. You're not at the
status.
Level.
Okay.
Right. So I could say, yeah, I mean, it's real.
Okay.
It's real.
What's your thoughts?
You know what, Mel, with these young guys now, I think it's real because I really don't know where I want to go with this.
Just go, this shop talk.
I'm constantly seeing it, like sometimes it's an issue where two are supposed to be friends.
Uh-huh.
And they wind up turning on each other maybe because of a girl.
Or okay.
Maybe because of some drugs, instead of trying to hash it out like two men, somebody wind up getting killed in most cases. So, yeah.
Okay. So you'll go with the status thing, like you said. It happens.
Like I said, I remember in 96, the streets got flooded with weed and dope and all that. And it seemed like they just dropped all that in the middle of a pack of lions.
Okay.
And whoever got to it first, was doing whatever. But whoever didn't, they would say the smartest person who didn't get to it first would go around and, just pick off the people that had it.
Okay. Well, is that your duffel bag boy?
Yeah. It's like, okay. I'm going to work for you, then I'm going to work for you, and I'm going to work for you. But, I mean, like I said, that's where I consider black on black crime. Sometimes, like my man was saying, you would kill each other just to try to be that man.
For stats.
Well, yeah. So just to be that guy. You're gonna kill whoever's around you. Just to be, regardless, it could be your boy, it could be your friend, or whatever. I mean, and then that's just what it is. Who can do it bigger? And now you have to sit back, especially, I know a lot of cats is not raising their kids right now. I know they're not, because they're not here to do it.
Okay, right.
So I think greed and establishment is I think what people are dealing with. Or was dealing with then.
Being a leader. Yeah. And it doesn't even have to be in an illegal, place. It doesn't have to just be illegal. It's like, okay, if I'm a certain status, as long as I'm in charge and I'm at the top, all is well. But as soon as you decide that you want to do something, guess what? You got to follow me instead of saying, okay, this world is big enough for every... We don't even have to come together. We still can be cool. You do your thing over here.
Right.
And then you can... Or how do we turn? Or like the younger generation coming in versus the older generation. Instead of saying, oh, okay, well, let me show you what to do. Even though we're doing, separate, we got different audiences. Let me show you. You're over here instead of being so selfish. The world is big enough for everybody to have some. Now, my next question is, do you believe that racism, or I don't even want to say self-hate because I don't hate myself. Do you think it's subliminal? Like when you look at Black Ice. Black Ice is cold outside. Why is it Black Ice supposed to be the worst?
I thought you were talking about the air freshener that you put in the car.
Nah, you crazy!
That
do smell good, though, the Black Ice.
A couple of those.
Oh, look at them. You're like, wait a minute.
Subliminal message.
We're not about to take my Black Ice.
Hey, somebody
out of my
white,
car.
Please chime in. Call in. Let me know you know anything about the Black Ice air freshener. Come on the show, okay? Black Ice. When snow is white. Snow is white, ice is clear, but it's Black Ice is the worst.
My Black Friday.
Black Friday. But Black Friday's supposed to be good, though.
But still, why come it just can't be something? Why does it have to be Black Friday?
Good question.
I don't get that.
Why when you need a jump on your car, the negative charge is black? those are things that you, devil's food cake, like angel food cake.
The main ball is white. Right. All the other ones is all colored.
Martin said
poo.
Martin
said poo. You're right.
The last one to go in the pocket is the black ball.
Yeah,
that means right.
Martin said it best. He was in Boomerang. He was like,
you're right. Like the white ball got it. Hit the black ball.
It's over when
the black ball is knocked in. And then the pool table was green because the world is green and everybody thought it was flat at one point in time. So,
oh, man. That had you jacked up.
If you take it that far, I guess. But Martin and Boomerang,
I ain't seen that movie in so long.
Man, everything was racist to Martin. Everything.
That's crazy.
You know, why they gotta be asparagus spears? Why can't it be asparagus tips? That's what
Oh, look. Dang, he went deep. Like, man. I didn't even really pay no attention to that.
I'm telling you.
So I guess that would be yes. It's subliminal. What you thinking about? Go ahead.
We can go. I could talk for hours on this, but we can go.
Blackmail. All right.
Yeah, blackmail.
If you're doing something or something like that and somebody got something on you, they're gonna blackmail you.
I think the bigger question is...
I just
want
to get him started.
Right, you didn't get him going. Go ahead, Roogle.
I understand the whole thing, like, you know, people use the word black to mean these negative things or whatever, but I think some of the issue is we're not... I mean, we're...
Brown.
Yeah, we're brown people, yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, you know, so like if we never, I don't know, like it was that movement, it went from Negro to black to African American
to other.
You know, I don't know.
You don't know?
I'm gonna have to go a little bit deeper in there so I can get it going.
What about we're
gonna talk relationships. So I got some husbands. I told you lovely ladies out there, y'all wanted to know. So we're gonna be open and honest with husbands that's gonna tell you exactly what you wanna hear. Now, I'll post like a shop talk question of the week or a question that I'm asking the fellas because you guys asked me this question, but it's mighty funny how you'll ask the question, and then when a guy gives you the answer, you don't want to hear the answer. You telling him why. And it's what is that about?
What did they say? What is it?
Yeah, which question?
Mother knows best. No, father knows best. What is it that women know? The thing is it's the thing.
I don't know that proverb.
I don't know what it is. What's
the question, man?
It's different questions just as far as like what an example would be. What do men really look for in a female? And then it's, you know, and a guy will say what he's looking for. Then and he'll like one guy was visual.
Mm-hmm.
And he said what he liked. He liked a nice body. And then the female got mad and attacked him. Well, it's him. It's him.
She was probably seeking a deeper answer. You know,
but if he's a visual person, that was his answer. All right, we're gonna talk about body counts. We're gonna go down the line. Body counts. Do you, when you're dating somebody, okay? All you guys are married,
mm-hmm.
but I need you to go back a little bit mm-hmm. and be honest. When you're dating someone, does the body count matter? How many guys she slept with? And I'm gonna go around.
I'm a gentleman, so I do not tell nor ask.
Okay, what's your thoughts?
Baby, if you are listening right now, push pause.
Go ahead.
I'm with my man. I don't ask. It's none of my business.
Okay.
It's really none of my business. And I do know guys who actually go that route and ask that question, then be arguing for the next six months.
Or you know, they end up losing a relationship because they're arguing over past stuff.
Right.
Okay. What's your thoughts?
I think, like, in most cases, like, if, you know, I'm pursuing a girl, and I don't always listen to hearsay, but I start hearing the same thing over and over again, I'm done.
You done?
I'm done.
So it matter. I know for us it matters.
All I'm saying
is, from a female, we want to know. Don't nobody want to be with somebody.
Well, think about it like this.
Who want to be with somebody?
Everybody wants to go to Disney World. Nobody asks how many people sat in the magic in the teacups. Right. I just want to ride the teacup. Let me ride the teacup.
And listen to A Small World for the whole thing. Yeah.
You know what else, Mel? There's sometimes, okay, like when I was running the street, sometimes I was just curious. Okay, is she really like that? Because I want to know.
Okay, now see, that's funny that you should say that, because that's the same thing here. If you have somebody, body counts matter to females. I'm going to say that, and I'm going to speak from the female's perspective. Yes, it matters, especially if it was somebody in my family, because I don't want to take you to the doggone reunion and you done knocked off everybody, but I need to feel like I got something special. That's the real truth. Now, just like what you said, T, you want to know, you know, people talk about all the tricks and all this other stuff. Okay. Same thing, some of us females, like, okay, well, can he do all that? Now, is he really the pastor? I can't remember. What's that pastor's name that was, like, on the Facebook? Like,
oh, the one that was on the video?
Yeah, the video. Like,
I can't think of his name.
Yeah, is the pastor really anointed? Pastor you want to know. So it's like, what'd you say?
Pastor Nasty. Nasty-ass pastor.
Now, why you gonna call him Nazi? Because they videoed it?
Come on.
Well, he didn't video it. The girl videoed it.
But he knew he was being videoed. Come on.
I don't know, because that wasn't even his wife.
He had to look up at least once.
You weren't expecting it to go viral. Go ahead.
Now, I'm gonna tell you this.
If they say a chick could suck a golf ball out of a net, you trying to not.
Throw a straw.
Or...
If you was kicking it with one of my guys,
okay,
I'm good. If we together for a little while or whatever, and we show up to go play basketball or something like that, and one of my guys be like, "Man, I used to kick it with her, man, back in such and such."
All right. Back in high school, and you 40.
I'm good.
You still good?
Man, I'm good.
What about you?
I'm good. I'm sorry. That's my boy. I know him. I know where he been, and you probably wasn't the only one he been with. So
y'all want no part. You ain't following behind him. Cool. Okay, go ahead. What's your thoughts?
You know what? I just think that people should not miss a chance. I'm going to say what the Cutlers say. Don't miss your opportunity to have a good relationship.
Okay.
What the Cutlers say.
Okay.
Cutlers, couples court. Comes on at 12 o'clock p.m.
They ain't pay for advertising, so we ain't. Go ahead.
It really just depends on the female. I could pass, but if it's just something I'm really, really curious about, that particular woman, yeah.
Okay, see, I love the honesty. Keep it 100. Man. Look at him, he a newlywed, he like,
Because I had a situation similar to that, and I walked away from something that I was like, man, I walked away from that. And, you know, I reflected on that for a while. But you had to walk, sometimes you got to walk away.
Mm-hmm. You think it could have been something? Or what if it was hearsay? I told y'all.
Oh, it wasn't hearsay.
Oh, what? Look.
Most fellas really get that no-no.
And it wasn't even like it was a whole lot of, like I didn't really know the history, but it was this one person, and I was like, damn.
You ain't want to follow behind that person?
No. But it wasn't because I was seeking out the knowledge. Like, I didn't ask her. I just happened to, you know, you fall into... Like, you fall into an answer that you didn't even know that was coming to you.
Okay.
Like, man, that was that? And then you was like, you gotta walk away.
Okay.
You know?
Did she like you?
Yeah.
But you had to walk away.
I had to walk away. It broke my heart for about a couple years after that.
Dang!
You see her at the mall, you're like, I walked away from that? Jeez.
She could have changed.
It Well, that's, sometimes you can change, but like there's certain viruses. When they change, it's only for the worst. Right. Like nothing.
Okay.
You know, and now you're going to say that. All right, go ahead. But you never know. It was just the dude was just so grimy and terrible. Man. I was just like, nah.
So it does matter who you've been with. All right. Now tell me this. Is it okay from a male's perspective to invest in relationships in this time? And the reason I say that is because sex is so callous now that they just like, boom, I meet somebody, I'm with them and all is well, and nobody's really dating the person. So at the beginning of a relationship, before you got married, did you invest? Did you date?
Did I owe my wife or just anyone?
Did you date or did you say, okay, well, we can go here for a date. We're going to use some coupons and didn't really court her.
My wife or just women in general?
Women in general.
I think you there's always, okay, I this is my answer to that question. Sometimes the courtship lasts as long as it takes you to get to a certain point in the relationship.
See, that's what I want to know.
Some cases you might have somebody who can court someone for a couple hours.
Yeah. And then you know that you out. Then you know you out. So that is that how you choose?
To court somebody for 90 days. I don't know. It just depends, you know.
So do you invest in a relationship at the beginning?
I invest in a relationship.
Okay. Yeah. What about you?
I've been doing it since I started. I'm a quote Tupac again.
Okay.
I don't mean to sound sleazy, but teasy. I don't want it if it's that easy.
Okay. You know what I mean? Well, okay, we got a rapper, Mike.
I don't want
Mike, you know what I mean? C, the rapper.
I really don't. Seriously, I mean, I think that if again, baby, push pause.
this is prior, so go ahead.
I think that you have everybody, every man out there has that person that they've seen and they just want just whatever it is.
Okay.
And every man has seen that person and they said, you know what, I want this for the rest of my life.
Pause that. Pin it. Go ahead. Do you invest in a relationship at the beginning?
Well, I've only had one that I did invest in at the beginning. But before her, no.
So how did you...
I was just... Okay, like I'm much older than most of y'all. And back when I was out there, it was just completely different than... You know, like they do a lot of online dating now.
Okay.
I know how to talk to a woman. Okay. I don't want to mess around and step in the wrong thing.
I want the truth.
I did a lot. Okay. And I didn't feel like I should invest, you know.
Okay.
Invested until there was one that changed all that.
Okay.
And I felt like, okay, this is the girl that I need to invest in.
Okay.
You know.
So you know off top, and this is for all of you, that's why I want you to pin that. So do you know if they are wife material or not going in? Like after that first date?
If you've been out there long enough dealing with different women,
mm-hmm.
you should know. Okay, so... I mean, I think I missed it sometimes, Mel, with like some girls that was really nice and I was completely different. And then I had a point in my life where it's like, you know what? I got this real nice girl. I got to stop. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So.
Okay, so
for
you
me,
just
it's
knew.
A little different than these guys because they're younger than me. And the way that you guys, which I don't know how y'all really went about mm-hmm. when you was pursuing a woman. Okay?
But
it's really not all the same. It's the stages are different, and you look like I'm a little older than you guys. So we were okay. I'm just go this far. I'm gonna leave it alone. When I was a young cat, I didn't know how to talk to a woman. Okay, and mm-hmm. she might like me, and I'm just, you know, I didn't have a.
Y'all had to see his eyes.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
What am I gonna do? This girl like me. I don't know what to say to her. So I went through a real bad, a shy stage. But then once I got it together, it's kind of like you couldn't shut me up. But I had to go through that first. You know.
So that shy brother, was that for real? Were you telling your boy, hey, go tell her?
I was for real. I was terrified.
Did you tell somebody to tell that girl you liked her?
I've done that before. I've been on the phone with a girl. She be talking to me. And I'm like, Oh, she'll say, like, I really like you, Taran. I'm like, oh, okay, and I like you too. But that's as far as it goes. I'm the one that's doing all the breathing.
Oh, you know?
I was that backwards.
Okay.
But I grew out of it.
You grew out of it, yeah. Clearly. Go ahead, Mike.
I like my man was saying, I think you know when you found that one. I mean, I think some things you don't, it's just that one relationship that you didn't do in prior relationships. You didn't start it off the same way. You didn't talk the same. You did things a little bit different. And like you were saying, I never had a problem with talking to anybody. I never had a problem. But here was my problem, listening. Now, I could talk on the phone with you all day. But now when you start talking, it's like, I'm really not interested. So what I did was I switched it up and I started listening a lot more.
Okay, so now break that down. You weren't listening. So what do you mean? You just like put the phone down?
Nah, I just basically said whatever I needed to say. I ran my game. If it worked, it worked. And after that, so what you up to? Most of the time I'm playing a video game or something like that. Sega. I'm going all the way back. I'm playing my video game.
Playing Shinobi.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Playing Tecmo Bowl with Bo Jackson or whatever. So I'm just playing my game and I'm listening. And after you're done talking, I'm hoping you didn't say, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm like...
Hoping you didn't say what?
Yeah, like anything important? Yeah.
Because you all know?
Because I know. Nope. I didn't know. I knew everything I said. But then after a while, I know... pretty much into that conversation if what I'm saying is working towards what I'm working towards or if it's not.
Okay.
And if it's not, then I'm, hey, you know what? It's my brother. I don't have to give you a call back.
Okay. All right. Go ahead, Roogle.
I just wanted to reflect on something that T said because I think that, excuse, I almost died. I almost choked on my
camera. I got you.
I just want to reflect on that because I think maturity plays such a strong role in that because it's not like men just date a string of just terrible women and then they just find the one sometimes. I think the thing is that sometimes you meet great people along the way and then you just may not be ready.
Okay.
And so like I remember once I was like, man, that was a really nice girl, but she really caught me at a bad time.
Okay, and so you just passed her up.
Well, I mean, it didn't work out because I wasn't who I was gonna be.
Okay,
you know what I mean. And I think that plays a role. Like, where are you at in your life to really look at and want to cultivate something special with that person? Because I thought about it. I was like, could I have been married before? Probably a handful of times. If, you know, and probably would have been divorced a handful of times. You know what I mean? You know? And it wasn't so much that I would say, this is just their fault. They're terrible, you know? But it was just like, the person I was at that time was not going to be the person that could... I mean, could I have made it work? Yeah, you make anything work. You work hard enough at it.
Mm-hmm.
But... you know, sometimes I think, like, my wife got the best me, but that's just because I was through so much early on. You know what I mean? Like, you know, I got beat into shape.
That's what happened?
That's what happened.
Other women molded you for be the perfect husband for somebody else.
Yeah, it was the montage before the big fight, you know what I mean?
Like, what you are saying, what I am hearing you say is that it wasn't the female... it was you.
It could be a combination of those things because you can say or do something that you don't really know is that impactful to like blow up everything.
Okay.
You can just say the wrong thing and that person can internalize and say, well, what if you just said that to me? Then maybe this wasn't supposed to be. Like, there was a girl I was dating. I really wasn't paying too much attention to her, really, really. And then one time she came to me.
Not clearly, that's what's happening.
I was paying attention, but I wasn't paying attention, right?
Okay.
And so she says to me, well, I got asked to go to Las Vegas or whatever from somebody. And I said, wow. And I guess it's supposed to be a dig at me. I said, are they paying for your airfare? She said, yeah. I was like, they paying for the hotel and everything? She's like, yeah. I was like, man, y'all going to Las Vegas. They probably going to give you some spending money, huh? She's like, yeah. And I was like, man, if somebody gave me a deal like that, you'd have seen me 4 days later. And the reason...
Now, listen, I ain't mad at you because I feel like that too.
But the reason I said that was because if you value what we had or what we could have worked towards, you wouldn't even came at me with no junk like that. You know what I mean?
But what if it was true?
It probably was true. And what I was saying was, go ahead and make your dreams come true in Las Vegas. You know what I'm saying? Because at that point in time, it was like, yeah, we was cool enough, and I'm glad you were honest enough to tell me the truth, you know, because if it only takes a trip, then take that trip. Because I ain't falling for it. Look at that. Puns.
Now, here's the thing. Now, since you use that analogy, what if that, like you said, that was the truth, but maybe she was just being honest and y'all were friends. There was no commitment. That wouldn't have did. Maybe she just was being honest. And you had a problem with that?
It wasn't like, oh, we, no, it was.
Y'all were more. Yeah. Okay, than her just going on a trip with another guy.
But the thing was, it was like, what are you trying to get out of me by telling me that? So
maybe she was honest.
All I was saying was like, if I was in Hawaii, I'd have gave her a hula dance and put a layover in and said, get on the plane. Because you told me who you are.
See, I don't agree with that all the way.
Well, I'm just saying.
Wasn't a committed relationship.
I don't know what you will
do. I'm going to go with no. Because if you can't answer that, then clearly it's a no. So y'all just picking it. So she's supposed to just be on standby?
No.
And if somebody paying for a trip.
If that happened to me, would I have jeopardized the relationship by saying this is something that's happening with somebody else? If it was, you know.
Was it a relationship, though?
I mean, every engagement with someone is a relationship.
Nah, you gotta be concrete now. You gotta be concrete. If y'all were in a committed relationship, yes, going somewhere else with somebody else
is an issue. What's a committed relationship?
What is a commit? You tell me. You the one that had the relationship with her. Did she know that y'all were together? Did she meet your grandmother? Did she go to Thanksgiving dinner?
It wasn't Thanksgiving time when I dated her.
Huh?
It wasn't Thanksgiving time when I dated her.
Did she meet your grandmother?
What?
See? Guess what? Vegas, here I come! Like, that's crazy! So you want her on standby?
I'm getting lightheaded. I'm about to die over here.
It's like, okay, so y'all can do what y'all want to do, but we need to be, okay, we just gonna wait and see where it goes.
Well, I mean, the thing was like this. If I were committed,
because I
wasn't committed no more.
Listen, no, but that's not okay, because if you told me that and I was dating you, I would be like, oh, he cool with it. Cool.
I'm saying, if that's what you want to do, then go ahead and do it. Don't ask
but
me.
But that don't mean
don't
that.
Don't ask me for permission for you to go off and do something that you want to do.
Did she ask you for permission?
I don't know what that was.
I was open and honest.
All I'm saying was, it was the time for me to say, hey, doing? This is not for me.
Now tell me what you think. We be going. Listen, Mike and T, look, me and Roogle going at. What's your thoughts?
What I'm trying to figure out is, you know, how you doing?
Listen, what's your thoughts though?
In
that scenario,
listener,
the problem in that scenario.
If
there's no commitment, she's just talking.
She was saying it to get a rise out of him.
See,
she was trying to get like, hey,
you think so?
I'm on my way to Vegas. When he hit her back with, hey, have a good time.
See, I wouldn't have got offended by that.
Oh, and I didn't get offended.
You said have a good time. But you said that you read more into it. So you flipped the roles. You read more into it because I know.
All I know is that if I'm taking a woman on an all-inclusive trip to anywhere on the planet, what's going down?
Not true.
If I'm taking her. You know what I'm saying? I'm not investing that kind of money and time into somebody that is not, there's no romantic connection with or something. Like, that was from my perspective. So, thinking from my little bit of knowledge at the time, I'm like, well, dang, this chick is telling me she about to go on the Vegas jump off. Cool. Okay.
Did she told you who she was going with?
No, I didn't ask.
What if it was her homegirls? What if it was a girl's trip?
No, the way it was implied, it was a man.
So maybe she said it to see if, like you said, get a rise out of you, to see if you cared enough. And then you said, go and have a good time. At least she got that memory.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I agree. See, go ahead.
Yeah.
I mean, because
I've never been in that kind of situation before. Yeah. But,
if I was like that, like you just explained, I'm saying, you know, you go ahead, okay? For me, with the type of person that I was then, I'm telling you to go ahead because I got
something going on here.
Something else going on. Hey. So have a good time.
Yeah, take
care.
Maybe
I'll see you in a
couple days.
That's what I'm saying. See, that's what I would think, because I would think that you guys are friends. Because if there's no commitment, you both are single.
I mean, by definition, you're single until you marry.
Yeah. Okay. Well, yeah, technically, and I still ain't putting you on my taxes because I ain't going to get enough money back. We got to marry but separate, get more back. But what I'm saying is, if you there's no committed relationship and y'all working on a relationship, I'm just going to keep it 100. I'm not working on a relationship and passing up a trip. I'm speaking for me.
And that's cool.
And I would look like, and I'd be like, oh, he's cool.
Candy doing this show, yeah. I'm about to die twice.
And I think that that's a good thing. And if somebody say, oh, okay, well, have a good time, this and that. I'm like, oh, he cool with it. We good.
Mm-mm.
See? Nah. But you know, remember, we had that one conversation. Yeah. Like, yeah. I don't see that. I'm like, now, when we actually come to the table and say, okay, we're exclusive, we're together.
It don't matter. Then, what you tell me about this trip, I'm going to already see the whole thing in my head.
And it's not necessarily true, though. Like he said, if he paying for it, boom. But, hey, you can take me on a trip. That don't mean I'm sleeping with
but
you.
I ain't saying that you do. From my perspective, if I'm devoting time and energy like that,
uh-huh,
then we already have a connection that's strong like that. Is what for
what
me?
What if she don't know? What if she don't know?
What you mean? What if she don't know?
What if she don't? T sat there and said he didn't really talk. So being that he might not have expressed himself, or maybe, and you said you don't listen. So if she on the phone talking and you doing whatever you're doing, not listening, she's like, well, maybe he's really not into me because I said this and this didn't happen. Okay.
I would hear a Vegas trip though. I bet you I would hear that. I'll tell you one thing.
And then you're going to get an attitude and respond differently. First of all,
I'm going to say, what? You going where? How long? Or whatever? Now.
Now you got an attitude, and then you saying, okay, I'm invested in this relationship, but she doesn't know that.
And then I say, hey, you going where for how long to do what? You going on an all-inclusive vacation to Vegas.
Okay.
Y'all got the same room. Y'all there for 4 or 5 days. Everything paid for. He didn't pay for everything.
Okay.
Okay. By the time you get back, that's pretty much done. I'm good. Yeah.
I think it's a double standard.
I think if a man told a woman that same thing, or anybody who's dating anybody, whoever that significant other was.
And if he said he had a sponsor.
Like a sponsor, like you going to do like humanitarian work or something.
It can be humanitarian work. You're going to speak to people.
Definitely. All right.
You're going to speak to Black and Jack. But that's not what's going on. Hold on. Go ahead. I'm getting a little sick of this. So if your guy that you talking to and y'all don't have the connection like you say you got.
Well, I ain't saying connection. I'm saying this is the beginning of a relationship, right, and you guys have not concretely said that we are in a exclusive relationship and we're dating.
He told you that, since he didn't feel like y'all was in that. He told you that he's going on an all-inclusive vacation with whoever for about 4 days, and he's paying for it.
See, he's paying for it. There's a problem. But if she's paying for it.
It's another girl on the other end.
But he's paying for it. So that means that he's investing in that relationship, which was the earlier topic that we talked about.
So the person who's taking you is not investing in that relationship?
That ain't got nothing to do with me because we ain't in an exclusive relationship. I'm going for the fun.
Man, there's a Pinocchio in the building.
I'm telling the truth.
So your man, your friend tell you that he's taking somebody on this all-inclusive.
See, that's very different. But listen to what you're saying.
Yeah.
You're saying, if my friend told me he was taking someone else, yes, there's a problem. If my friend, and we not in an exclusive relationship and didn't come to terms with each other that way, and we just kicking it, and he says, this girl is taking me here and there, listen, bye, have a good time. I'm not mad at you because we did not come and say, okay, this is an exclusive relationship. I'm still going to do me on the side. But I'm going to tell you, listen here, homie, go. Vegas is fun. Because guess who ain't got to take you to Vegas? Me. And you can say, I went to Vegas. So then when you come down,
you're not going to have no conversation about that trip at all.
Why? It ain't got nothing to do with me. Because who knows? I'm probably in Vegas over there staying at the Caesar's Palace too. I'm just keeping it 100.
I mean, I understand.
So when you're single, you can be with whoever you want to be with, but when y'all come and it's exclusively you come together and say, okay, well, I want to be with you. Let's say we are together and we are dating. Then it's different. Do you see a problem with being sponsored by a female now?
Who, me?
Sponsored by a female. Hey. What do you mean when you say
sponsored by a female? Because, I mean, I got gum, but I can understand the choking. What do you mean? What do you mean? Like, if she say she's going to pay for my all-inclusive trip to Vegas. Mm-hmm. And
she paying your bills and she doing whatever she's doing. You just going over to her house with the gray sweatpants on.
Okay. So.
The gray sweatpants.
That's on you, T.
Ah! He passing it.
We'll pass it over here. I'm with my little sure lifeline.
You don't have a problem with a female sponsoring you, taking care of you?
Then.
Okay. Huh?
Then. When I was...
Well, then you wouldn't have... Okay. What about you?
I think that you have... Like, for example...
Uh-huh.
Me and a really good friend in college, we had this conversation, and he said to me, I don't know if I could marry a woman who makes more money than that's what he said, what? Right?
Yeah.
I thought it was crazy. So I told him, I said, yo.
Well, his dating pool just went down.
I was like, so you ain't dating no supermodels. No musicians, no doctors, no, like you, so who are you? So either you gotta make a whole lot of money, or, you know, I just think, like, sometimes people are better positioned than another person. That's like, so for example, if my wife, technically she does make more money than me.
Go ahead. I mean?
So if she's making more money than me, am I going to be like, I'm going to be mad? Be like, oh man, look, she's making more money than me. I feel inadequate. That's ridiculous.
Okay.
I know who I am.
That, though. The trip about that very thing right there, that they woman, they girl, wife make more money than them. And they have a real issue with it. And myself, I'm good. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
My wife made more money than me. Wasn't an issue. We worked in the same place. And she was making more money than me.
Okay.
She was making more money when she was just my girlfriend.
So you knew she was getting already.
Okay. But I work with a guy. I'm kind of just gonna switch this up a little bit. This guy that I work with. His wife can pick up his phone. No. Yes, she could pick up his, but he ain't allowed to pick up hers.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Well, what's that mean? That means that she making moves. That's real talk. I'm putting it out there. She making moves.
I ain't going to go no further because this story can really be out there. But I'm just saying, I'm listening to this guy talking. I'm looking at him like...
Does she make more money than him?
Yeah.
Oh, so she like, turn these lights off. Like, come in the house like, turn these lights out. And he's running up to the electric bill.
She basically run everything, you know.
And he allows it.
Yeah.
See, that's a little different. Would you want to piggyback off that?
Yeah, okay. I mean, no, my wife makes more money than I do. And she's an educator, you know, and I work in the schools too. It doesn't bother me. No, it doesn't bother me at all because, you know, she's still what I consider still just my helpmate. I don't say, hey, since you make more money than I do, you pay everything right. And I'll just sit back and help. No, I still do exactly what I'm supposed to be doing as a man or whatever. Now, if I need something, then I can go to her and say, hey, I need this or this needs to be done or whatever. She doesn't have a problem with it. But I don't, I mean, it is what it is. All the money's coming in the house. It's going to the same, pretty much the same thing. And it doesn't bother me at all.
Okay. Do you have a problem with your wife picking up your phone and looking through it?
Oh, I didn't know it was on that
one.
We part.
On that one now.
This is how I feel about it.
In that case, since no comment.
It is. Because I want to say,
Wait. Go ahead, Roogle.
I want to say something about what was earlier said about the one scenario with the guy. Like, okay, looking at her phone and knowing her routine.
Uh-huh.
Was any, like, I wonder if anything was he ever like, I wonder where she is. You know what I mean? But I can't look at her phone. I kind of feel like the
You already know where she had her phone. There she is. Well, she
had the house. No, I'm talking about other times than that that would make looking at the phone for information valuable. Okay. I kind of feel like phones are it's the last frontier of personal space.
Okay.
You know, I mean, it is. And the thing is, it may not be so much like, okay, a person is trying to cheat on you or whatever, but I could be having a conversation with a sibling, a parent, you know, a confidant about a situation they're going through. And they, because I think everyone's had a situation where it's been like someone's confided in you, and that, and them confiding in you means you, not you and your wife. Okay. Not you and your girlfriend or boyfriend or whatever, just you.
Just you. And not no pillow talk later on about that situation.
So I think sometimes, like, I look at it as the last frontier of your private self. Mm-hmm. I mean, granted, you know, all the, you know, I'm not talking about Google spying on you and all that stuff. That's different. But I'm just saying, like, if I want to have a thought or conversation with somebody, sometimes heavy conversations nowadays happens through text. Okay. And it's not something that I'm trying to be underhanded or treacherous in my relationship, mm-hmm. but it's just like, it's for a need to know. This information is for a need to know. Okay. And you don't need to know.
Okay.
I don't touch phones. I never have, and probably to this day, I never will. I just don't. It's none of my
business. There's nothing on my phone that my girl can't see. I'll come in the house and leave the phone and she won't figure it out. I don't care because there's nothing there.
Okay.
And she might run through a conversation where I was giving somebody the blues, another cat of twos about something, but that's about the extent of it. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, as a matter of fact, there's even other women I talk to. Friends, but that's it. You know, mm-hmm. she picked it up and she seen that and she questioned me. I wouldn't trip about it. Where's it such and such?
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Okay, so it's pretty much open.
I don't care.
I didn't forget my phone at home all the time.
Uh-huh, so there's
And it's pretty much, you know.
So when a guy has a problem with their spouse or female picking up their phone, what does that usually indicate? And I want to hear from you guys. I'm not guessing from a female's perspective that...
Have you lightly... Dude is creepy. He's creeping. For real.
If my phone rings and I'm knocking you over to get to it, you know, I'm like, oh, you know what, that's just my brother. And if I'm doing that, I mean, it is what it is. I mean, my daughter, my wife, like your brother's calling, your dad's calling.
Because it comes up on the phone.
It comes up on the phone or whatever. Like, she got a watch on her wrist, and you can tell when everybody's calling or whatever. Her phone goes off a lot more than mine. She got social media and all that or whatever. Sometimes, and I try to look away. Uh-huh. Sometimes me and my wife be sitting there, we might be watching a movie or something like that, and something comes up on her phone. She'll open it up be like right in front of me or whatever. And I'm trying to look around her because I'm not paying no attention.
Right.
And I think that's a good thing because it shows that there's trust. Right. I'm not asking for a guy's phone unless I need to see something or I'm telling you, hey, look that up for me real quick or something like that. But not, or my phone, because y'all already know I'm in the dinosaur ages. I don't have it like newer thing. I'm like, hey, let me see that phone. Or my battery is not. It has to be a reason behind it. It's not just to go and search through your phone. Because here's the problem. If we have to search through your phone, you know what that means. That means what? That means that there is no trust. And if there is no trust, guess what? Might as well not even be there in that situation.
Absolutely.
That's the way that I feel.
I agree.
You know what I'm saying? So, and what he was saying, and there is a lot of times where you might get a message where they don't want it to be shared with somebody else. Or it's like, hey, I'm going through this and they don't want somebody else, you know, want it to be shared with somebody else. And you are married. It's like, don't do the pillow talk. You know what I mean? Like, if I'm sharing something with you, can you please not discuss that with your husband? Because now when I see you, it's you and your husband looking at me. You know what I mean? And that's not what you want, especially if it's like a friend or something like that. How do you deal with that situation?
I think the issue is you. Friendships have to be respected. I mean, I get it. I understand, like, okay, your spouse is your best friend or whatever like that. But the thing is that there's if people rely on you and they rely on you to especially be a confidant, then I think that's sacred space. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't need to be violated by everybody.
Okay. You know. Okay. That's pretty good. That was well said. Roogle,
I think about that a lot. I mean, because it's like, I mean, I don't think about it like it's on my, cell phones, like it's a pressing issue. But I remember one time I got questioned about, why do I have a lock on my phone? Well, because I'm not always at home. I'm everywhere.
Now, here's my question. Here's my question for that. Did you have the lock prior to getting married?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So to me, like, why ask it? That this is how it was when I came on the scene. So I mean, now if your phone was unlocked and then all of a sudden we get married, now you're locking your phone. I'm like,
but I'll give you a good example about how quickly stuff, and this isn't even a phone issue, but uh-huh. Think about all the stuff that's on your phone. And if you just have your phone, just like, for example, I had a birthday not too long ago. I had people over my house, right? Mm-hmm. I called Amazon and I was like, hey, I'm trying to check out this charge because I got this one thing on there. And they was like, oh, on this day, blah, 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 you ordered Showtime. I was like, what are you talking about? I didn't order nothing. You know what I mean? Somebody over my house, you watching TV, press the button on the television and now I got Showtime. You know what I mean?
Okay.
I'm just saying like. I mean, and that may not, the thing I'm trying to say is that your life is so, everything is so accessible to your life on your phone. If you, the thing about it, if you pay a bill, if you get your bank account or something set up on there or anything like that. So it's almost, you're almost foolish not to have your phone locked if you know that you are in situations where you may leave it out.
Okay.
You know, that was so my situation is I keep a lock on it and I all change right. it periodically.
Anybody from Live Studio Audience want to add to that? That would be a no. What's up to the Live Studio Audience? I appreciate you guys being there. Yeah, look at the Live Studio Audience in the building. I got another question for you lovely fellas. Do you do what women do as far as when they say, hey, hook me up with somebody? Are you okay with hooking somebody up to find a good man? When they say, find me a good guy, I want one of your friends. They're like, oh, you are a nice person. I see how you are with your wife. Hook me up with one of your friends. Not realizing that's not them. That's their friend. Go ahead. Are you okay with hooking people up?
Nope.
Oh, that was easy. Why?
Because I'm not my problem.
You don't want that phone call? That's
not my problem.
You that phone told call late
me
at night.
Stacy was cool. You told me flat out that Stacy was cool. You said she was gonna be the best thing for me. I get home and Stacy is Steven. Nope.
Yeah.
Nope. Don't even want to. Nope. Not in my business. That's on you. Because man, I would not be in this position if it wasn't for you at the barbecue. Man, I would
Because they're going to constantly call back.
Man, you know her? Yeah, went to school with her. How is she? She was cool in the 10th grade.
You mean specific. She was cool in the 10th grade.
But now, you know.
I don't really know.
I don't know what's going on, but go do your thing.
Okay, what about you?
I think you do it with a disclaimer.
What's a disclaimer?
Disclaimer is like,
you're not allowed.
From what I know of this person, they seem to be okay. But you have to have the wherewithal to know when to bow out if it's not all right for you. You know, don't blame me for the outcomes of an introduction.
Okay. Mm, you ain't hooking up, not at this age. You like, you done?
No.
Hook yourself up?
Yeah, that's how I kind of look at it. You know, you are, if you find somebody in front of the truck, you go over there and talk to them. Because if I do it and it don't turn out the correct way, then you're going to be looking at me. Like,
yep. No. Cookouts ain't going to be the same.
I will do this.
Someone said, look what happened. Look what I did to me.
I will do this, though. Honestly, if I know more about the individual than my friend does, I will be like, hey, do you, but.
Oh, so, okay, so you going
okay, so now.
You going to give them a warning.
Hey, do you, but look out for this. Well, why are you saying that? But well, this is what I know about this individual from my perspective. You've been trying to holler at her ever since we got here to the picnic.
Okay.
And you're like the ninth person who tried to holler at her. So it's eight other dudes out here who got her number just today.
But how do you know those eight other people have the number? Maybe she didn't give those eight other people the number.
I know Amanda. She's a number given boy.
I hope that's a alias. Yeah,
I know her. You're 9 o'clock, bro.
What if she has the right to play through the field too, to say, yeah, I don't think I like this guy, I don't like this guy, I don't like that guy. Because think about it like this. Women probably, I think on average, like a woman just walking throughout the day is probably get hit on a ton of times. You know what I mean? Like,
And don't ask.
You know, yeah.
Did somebody try to talk to you at the store? That's going to get you out, blocked, deleted, straight up. Somebody try to talk to you at Walmart? What? Nobody paying attention to that.
If I know full fledged that Amanda is a taste tester, buddy, listen to me.
She's not a sample.
A
snack.
That is pretty much, and that's all I'm gonna give you. Now, okay. After you still pursue that bottle of water,
okay,
and you find out that it is not as thirst quenching as you thought, you cannot come back to me and say, "How come you didn't tell me?" I forewarned you. I told you.
Well, or do what T said. I ain't got nothing to do with it. So if you talk to the individual, you on your own.
Well,
now see,
me and my brother are still going through that one right now.
I'm just saying, y'all still going through that one. I just think sometimes you meet some lovely people through other people. I think you do. I just think you gotta know when something ain't right for you. I mean, something like, hey, somebody can say, hey, this is a nice person or whatever, blah, blah, blah. And if it don't work out,
Okay, remember the one girl you was dating and all was well until she littered in her own yard?
Oh, yeah. But I met her at a party. Yeah.
Okay. Let me catch you up if you don't. He met some young lady and they went out and everything was fine until they pulled up and she had to clean her car out and she threw a bag of trash outside in her own yard. He was done. Straight turn off.
Yeah, that was at the beginning of the date. I knew it was over.
He knew it wasn't a future.
Because I had to drive a distance to meet her. And then she said, because you drove here, I'll drive around. And I was like, cool, because I didn't really know the place all that well anyway. And so we get into her car. She had some trash in her car, like a fast food bag or whatever, in a cup, and she puts it in the, you know, she just throws it outside of her car, and it's like a dumpster, like 10 feet away. You could have walked in through the way, but anyway. So we go on a date, we come back, bag still there, you know, like she don't throw it away. And so the next day I call her and I was like, hey, did you ever throw away that bag? You know, and then she was like, what? Like, from her response, I know she didn't throw it away. And so it's...
So you knew there was no future.
In my mind. It's this bag. This is blowing around this city. Because she didn't throw it away. And that's my pet peeve, is littering. Especially...
But, I mean, you can look at that. Like, if she gonna litter in her own yard...
She didn't care about nothing.
Thank you. See, that's what I would look at. Her house would gotta be nasty.
Been there. I mean, I'd say this all the time. And I am so frustrated when I say this, people. It is some beautiful women on this planet. I mean, they are. What the most filthiest houses I ever seen. I broke up with somebody over it. I'm trying to lie to you not. Broke up with them. Invested even.
You invested? And then you went to the house.
I invested 23 hours into this individual.
You Jack Bauer?
Finally made it to Graceland. Opened up the door and it was just ha.
Oh man!
You know, don't move stuff around on the table to make a spot. Clean it up. There was nothing. When you got to sit down and move a coat or a jacket or a hat or a baby, you got to clean up your house.
It was this unattended baby.
And you try to get over it because she is so amazing looking. But you just can't get over the potty that she's staying in right now. So, hey, I got to go. And you just never would believe. You can't just clean up when Section 8 is going to show up tomorrow.
Dang! Inspection?
You have to be able to keep your house clean before the... I mean, I know the inspector is coming. Got it. Ah, we get it. But You got to be able to, if your oodles and noodles are hard in the pot, you have not.
The water didn't evaporate it.
I am trying to tell you.
So it was a turn. Did you go to the bathroom?
I did not make it past the front room, people.
You went home?
The baby. She didn't move the baby.
It's miscellaneous babies.
It's baby. So I got in the car and not called my brother because I love him. I said, man, you cannot believe what just happened to me. You remember so-and-so? It was a baby. Y'all think I'm joking. You got clothes, hats. You see what I'm saying? You got clothes, hats, and everything, and then it's a baby sleep. Like in
wait. I got the idea that y'all were out and came and went to her home.
Right.
You know he did the CPS man, so he needed to know.
Okay. So once again, we add on to that. And it's about 18 other individuals living the same house with you. Not to forget, you almost sat on a baby. People?
So this is a full right, house. Yeah, that's so nasty.
I'm good.
Man.
Okay, so if the house is nasty, that's a turnoff.
Yes. Now is it?
So is that still it? Go ahead. House nasty, turn off.
It's a bag blowing around Cincinnati right now. He's still mad about
it. What
are you talking about is like, because I will say, well, a little clutter, there's no issue with
don't
that.
Organize
mess. But a part of your clutter is like miscellaneous babies.
It's a baby.
It's something wrong there.
I'm talking, not a puppy, because you know puppies scurry. This was a baby.
No, it's like I'm done.
I'm good. You got your towel hanging on the outside of the bathroom door? No.
Huh?
Yeah, no, I'm good.
How the towel on the outside of the bathroom door? On the knob?
It's on the knob. Yep, nope.
So you got to have a clean house.
Oh, yes you do.
Now, there was somebody, shout out to Damon, that's my cat, because he usually come on the show and chat. His issue was, he said when he go into a female's house, when it's getting ready to go down. Why you here that day?
Yeah.
He said the first thing that he does is go in the refrigerator.
They check the cupboards.
And check the cupboards. Yes. He said if ain't no food, he leaving. That means she can't cook for him afterwards. So he was like, I'm out. So now fellas are pretty much calling the shots and is like, no, I'm not no.
I'm good.
So it's for the young people out there, clean your house.
Clean up your crib.
So tell me, does that mean that she might not have cleaned her box?
It could be. Here's the thing. Man. Something.
If her house is nasty, her box nasty?
I'm believing
that. Is that how you think, honestly?
Your discretion advised.
If you're trying on a whole bunch of clothes to go out, that's cool. You know, you can lay a shirt here or a dress here or something like that. But if it's laid from, like, the room all the way to, like, the back door... No.
Did
you just, you know what I'm saying? Or you go, I got to go get my shirt and put it on. And you go downstairs, you get it out the dryer, you put it on. Okay, we got that. But So
an organized mess, like what he was saying, like a little bit of, then it's all good.
I had that complex for about 10 years about all pretty women. I know your house is just filthy.
Oh, man. Yeah, you were scarred.
Hey, y'all should have seen it in his eyes.
Yeah. He was serious. Like, what?
You know, now... I know that some women don't keep their cars clean. I know that. You know, my wife, she a receipt will be everywhere. You know? So I go in there and I clean it up or whatever. But I know for a fact she keeps the house clean. You know?
Okay.
So when I first met her, that's one thing. I go in and as soon as you go through a door, if you've ever been in certain situations, you can go through a door and you can see the whole apartment. You can see
is what I'm going to say to you, and I'm glad that you brought that up. You look at a woman's house, we look at your car. If your car is nasty, be like, uh-uh.
So my car can be dirty and my house can be clean and you good.
I'd be like, mm-mm. I'd be like, mm-mm.
Couldn't wash my car because I was too busy cleaning my house.
No, the inside.
Oh.
The inside.
Yeah.
And we look at that. Look at him laughing. Yeah.
The wintertime.
And be like, oh, yeah, he don't clean up. He nasty. If his car is nasty, I know I'm going to be cleaning up. If I marry him, I'm going to have to clean. That kind of gives the idea, and this is just for me, that gives the idea of what I'm getting ready to walk into. Now, a fast food bag or something like that, okay, I've seen where that's in the back seat, but the front seat looks clean because a guy usually takes pride in his vehicle. And that's what we look at, like, oh, okay.
I'm just telling you, I've been hurt by this situation.
Clearly, you still stuck.
I'm hurt by it.
You're hurt by it because you stuck with the baby.
Yeah.
But I got over it. I think the baby's like 9 now.
But 9, the baby made it to 9, so we have
right. So I'm just thinking that if because you're teaching as you grow, you know, you grow up, you know, the baby's probably gonna have a clean house. But the baby just
well, the baby is gonna have a clean house if the house is usually nasty because they want a clean house, so they're probably like, okay, I'm gonna make sure that it all is well. All right, well, here we go with this one. Have you ever had the question from a female that asked you, what were you thinking?
You're talking to 3 men. You're going to elaborate on this one.
You're sitting there, you talking, and boom, and it's like, so what's on your mind? What you thinking?
Oh, like what I'm thinking. Okay, see, that's not like, what were you thinking?
No, like, I don't know what that is. Is that like male?
Like I made a peanut butter and tuna sandwich. Yeah. What were you thinking?
No.
You know, okay.
What's on your mind? What are you thinking?
On my mind.
Yeah. That's what it should have been called. That's what this should have been on my mind. Has anybody ever asked you that question?
I kind of like, and that's another violation. Sometimes I'm like, I just want, like, sometimes I'm just thinking about stuff. And sometimes.
Space! This is some space guy.
But when you think about space. Stuff, like, you ever have one of those situations where you're like, okay.
Let me have my own thoughts?
Yeah, you gotta, before you can invite other people into it, you gotta work it out yourself. And that's the thing. It's like, okay, I really don't want to talk about it, but know that it doesn't have anything to do with you. And that's not even a good disclaimer. Because
No, it's not, because we'll have an issue with that.
Yeah, well, why won't you share with me? Because I haven't formulated the thought to share it. I'm still working through it.
So that's it. So it's not being a spouse, it doesn't mean that he's just neglecting you, still trying to work through your thought.
Yeah, because some things you got to be able to say. You got to be able to categorize it and work through it yourself, you know, at some point before it can be shared. It's like if you bake a cake, if I bake a cake, I want to give you the cake after it's been in the oven. I want to give you just a bowl of
batter,
yeah.
Okay.
And say, you know, put a candle in it.
Okay, go ahead.
He shot it to me.
I'm a little deep.
Look, what was you thinking? Honestly, it depends on the situation.
Okay.
Or what did you ask me about? What was I thinking? And in some cases, maybe the other half don't want to talk.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it's like, okay, we'll come back to it later.
Okay.
Like that. I mean, because sometimes I'm guilty of not opening up when I should.
Okay.
Okay. I just say it depends on the situation.
Oh.
Or what you're asking.
That's what we asking. So what's on your mind? You over there thinking, so what's on your mind? What you thinking about?
That's what I'm saying.
You already know that's coming. No. Go ahead.
I'm visual.
Uh-huh.
I'm very visual. So my wife asked me, what am I thinking? I don't do that. Because, I mean, she already, I'm visual, and plus I make jokes out of pretty much everything.
Okay.
So you can't really ask me what I'm thinking. Something's going to come out of my mouth, something ridiculous. So I think, but if there is something on my mind, though, or whatever, and that's like my man said, and I haven't yet figured out a way to actually verbalize it yet, then I'd be like, you know, we'll get back to it. You know, I can't really say. I know what I'm thinking, but I know it's not going to come out the way that I just scrambling around in my head a little bit.
Okay. My next question. What is it that you want women to stop doing? That's a turnoff.
What you thinking?
I answered that question. What you thinking?
Yeah, what you thinking? None of your business. It's my mind. I got to share that with you. Jesus.
I'm like, I'm about to break these glasses. Like, I done broke
my leg already. That's why we got to share a bed. If I have a sandwich, you want a bite of it. I can't have my own thoughts.
Now, speaking of the thought of a sandwich, I know somebody who went all the way to the left all because of a female wanting the bite of a sandwich. And you saying, not you per se, but the guy saying, no, it's his sandwich.
Yeah. Yeah, because it's one of those things. It's like, especially if they have the opportunity to get what they want. Like, you don't have to have my stuff. You have your opportunity.
What? You ask. So you ask a question. What do you want? And they said nothing. And then you got yours and they want it.
Yeah, but even if they got something, if it's not my something, you leave my something alone and have your nothing or your something.
Okay, what's your thoughts?
You can pretty much. Where is my daughter? She'll tell you. You can pretty much have anything off my plate. You can reach over and say, you just can't have nothing thick, like milk, or orange juice.
Oh, you ain't sharing that stuff?
Ice cream. Oh, my God. You cannot eat my ice cream. Listen, if I leave some ice cream in the room and you say, I might have had some, it's yours. I can't do it. I'm gonna tell you why. I love my mama to death. God rest her soul. I had some chocolate milk. Good cold chocolate milk. I think I might have been 9.
Back to that 9 again.
Ooh, I might have been 9 years old. And I came back to drink my chocolate milk and it had that greased lip ring in the inside of the cup.
Grease. Oh, her lip gloss?
No. It's like you
like she had ate something.
Like she
before.
Ate something and then drunk some of it and it was that grease lip ring.
This kid, you visual. He's like, you scarred.
And she put it down. And I went to go get it, and I seen the ripple of the lip grease ring going from one side of the glass to the other. I was done. I said, never again will I ever drink anything dairy after people. That and like dark pop. I just can't. I
because you can see the grease. You can see the grease in dark.
Yeah. The grease. Well, what is this grease?
It's like a grease yeah. lip ring. Like you got sweat on the top of your lip or something like that.
I don't know nothing about that.
Okay, eat something fried one time and then drink out of the glass, and then you can see that, it like
that,
floating.
That like ring, it's not like a wave on the pop or something.
Yeah, it's not like backwash, but it's just like the.
So your whole lip in the cup.
Listen,
well, your lip is hitting the juice.
It's hitting the top of it. So I do not drink milk, juice, dark pop, so nothing after nobody. You can have it.
You can have it. They just got it.
You can have it.
All right.
No one but my wife. Nobody.
Not even her.
I'm sorry.
No one else. I agree.
So what? Okay. So same question that I pose. What is it that you would like to tell women?
Don't drink my milk. Don't put your lips on my milk. Women,
let me get T's response. Is there anything that's a pet peeve that you wish that women would stop doing? Or you just
my pet peeve? Don't hit me in the back of my head. I hate that.
Don't hit you
in
the back of
your head. Don't hit me in the back of my head.
Now, why would somebody put their hands on?
I'm just saying. I mean, just playing. That just, it irritates me.
Okay.
I hate that.
Okay.
That's me.
You know. Okay. What you think about? Go ahead.
My pet peeve for my wife or just
women? Anybody, just in general.
Oh, my God.
We try to get these women my wife, husbands.
Listen, put something on your feet.
Oh, you don't like barefoot?
Oh, my. No. Because you're just walking around.
The floor might be dirty.
The whole house. You get
right step on the baby.
But then you got the baby with no socks on it. But you walking around the whole house. She texted me now because I know she hear me. You walking around the whole house just walking through stuff. If you have a pair of white socks on and those socks are completely dirty when you're done. Not saying that our house is amazing, but it's just little dust people. Then you go and put your feet in the bed. Me. Oh, my God.
Yeah, that's something with me. All right, we already know.
Before you go to him, come back to me.
Okay.
I'm done. Nope, because I'm having palpitations right now.
Hey, this is so real for him, man. It's like,
oh my God, those are just things.
You got to debrief after the
yeah,
show.
Yeah, right. Go ahead, T.
If I'm talking to you,
and
somebody else walk up and stick their nose in there, that just, I'll go completely off. Stay out of my conversation. That's my real big one right there.
No, that's a good. That's just disrespectful.
But
people just come.
You talking about in general, though?
I'd be surprised if the people with you be talking, and they'll just. I work with a cat just like that, and I done had to tell him a couple times.
And he just come in and just start talking.
Stay on my conversation. it's a little worse than that. I don't want to do this. You know. On
okay.
Radio, but it gets real nasty. Mm.
You know? Oh well, yeah. People being buttoning your business, and usually what females buttoning business. We want to know what's going on. What happened?
That was just in general, though.
Yeah, his was in general, but let's talk about what happened. We want to be involved. We want to be here for you. We want to be supportive.
Do you? Really? Yes. Really, you just want to know?
You just want to be nosy.
What? Y'all all said the same thing. We want to be supportive.
Supportive?
Yes. Here's something.
Is it going to be that support where you dial a friend and be like, you know what I just heard? What do you think about that? And then that friend call a friend, you know what I just heard? What do you think about that?
And they just goes on and on and on. Uh-huh. On and on. And then we want to talk about it later on, pillow talk.
Yeah.
So what happened? So what did you do? What were you thinking right now?
Nothing.
Yeah. And that's what you did?
It's only out.
It's only out?
It's the only out. I thought I was thinking nothing. I was just trying to keep my breathing. I was just focusing on breathing.
That's it? So what about commitment? Do you find that it is hard for black men to be committed?
No.
No?
No.
Mm-mm. No, I think we cool.
Look, speaking to black men that are committed. Mm-hmm. No? Nah, it's not?
If you make it that way.
Okay.
It's hard to be committed if you're not ready to commit.
Kind of like what Roogle was saying earlier. Yeah,
so that's just that.
Yeah. I'm probably going to go in a minute. But.
Okay. Cake and eating it too. How you feel about your cake and eating it too? Before. Your cake and eating it too. Black love. Your cake and eating it too. Like when you were a player. I ain't going to say all of y'all were players. But when you were single. Mm-hmm. When you were single and while you were fishing to find the perfect person, did you find yourself having your cake and eating it too? Like dating more than one person? And was it okay?
Well, if you dating is not, you know, if you date, I think you can date multiple people.
Okay.
I mean, you know, like you said, it depends on what y'all define y'all relationship to be. Are you at a point of being, what is the word, monogamous?
Okay, know? So do you think, is that conversation, because we know Mike said he don't listen. He said he's quiet. Look, I'm just going to put that out there. And you said, well, she should know where we are. Do you think that it is? I'm just saying what y'all saying. Y'all can rewind the tape and you can hear. Mm-mm. Now, here's the thing. You ain't say that.
And then I said, listen back in Sega Genesis days.
Okay, so wait a minute. Do you think that it is fair to say with people that are dating, trying to find love, to actually come and have that conversation and say, hey, are we going to be in a exclusive relationship, or do you just let that go?
You're saying if we have that conversation?
Is it like guys, just from a male's perspective?
That contract conversation?
That contract conversation. When do you have that?
I think sometimes it just grows into that. Like you'd be like, oh, I find myself not calling anybody else.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, I find you being the was it lovely distraction of my day.
And now that is really nice, a lovely distraction of your day. Now that's well said.
Because that line was used on me. I got camped. you're a lovely distraction. I'm sure I am.
Okay. Now here's the thing. When do you have that conversation though? So all of a sudden everybody else then fell off and you find yourself just communicating with that one individual. But if that one individual, if that conversation is not had, the other person don't know that that's there. Because at the beginning, remember, y'all just dating. And it's okay to date multiple people. Remember, we had the whole Vegas conversation.
Yeah.
So when is the right time to have that conversation, the contractual conversation?
I found myself in a relationship and I was puzzled. I had no idea how we got here.
So you just happened to be in a relationship.
I said... I didn't even know where we was at right now. We were going strong, and I had no idea. This is the words, though. I feel like I cannot talk to anybody else but you. I feel like it's just only you. Do you agree? Yeah. I mean,
did you say that you just fell into a relationship?
I agree with you saying you feel like you can't talk to anybody else. Yeah, I completely agree. But you never really asked me if is this the same individual? Because I've probably been pissed. I was pissed too. But so you never really asked me. It just happened. It was like it was a pitcher of Kool-Aid, and then just sugar just happened to get into that Kool-Aid. I had no idea that I was here, that we were here, and then all of a sudden we're there.
Okay.
And we're so
deep. And would you just go along with it?
I had to.
Why?
It's like quicksand. You know, I tried to backpedal, but the more you try, you sink even quicker.
Oh.
I tried to, and then I was like, well,
you know what? Started being posted, right. We together?
And I was like, you know what, well, I guess.
That's it?
This'll do.
Okay.
I was just there. That was long time.
I've been with her for 3 hours, and I get home, and I call her.
Okay. So you call her after you've been with her the whole time, and you know that's the one.
As soon as I hit the door, I ain't sat down. I'm on the phone trying to talk to you some more, and I just left you.
Okay.
Wow.
That's,
I know.
So that's
Usher. You got it bad. Right.
That's a special. That's when was that conversation? When was that conversation had to say we're together? Or did you fall into it like them?
I probably did.
You just fell into it? You're like, okay, oh, well, we together. Okay.
This is the woman that I'm going to be with.
I think, well.
Go ahead.
Just to add to that, I think you know if you feel like you need to hide. if you feel like, man, would she be, am I doing something that I'm going to regret doing if she were to find out?
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like sometimes it could be that conscious feeling of like, yeah, I'm pretty committed here. I don't know if I should take this, I see this lady, I think she looks nice, but I don't think I should get her number because I had this other thing going. And how do I explain having that number if I think this is a good thing over here?
Maybe you could just talk to her and ask her. And be like, hey, I got this girl inviting me to dinner. What do you think?
What do you think? She's like, dinner for three?
Right.
Yeah, nah.
It'd be like a Vegas trip. This is like,
man. Oh, man.
All right, we are coming to a close. I thank you guys for coming on the show and kicking it with us and shop talking with me because I needed to know when is the right time to have that conversation and do you know, this is the last one, did you know when she was the one? That's all I'm going to ask, yes or no?
Did you know when she
did
was
you the know one? When your wife was the one?
I did.
You knew?
Yep.
Okay, how long did it take you?
If he say 3 hours, I'm going to lose.
No. It was just instant.
Was it instant? Okay.
I can't tell you how long it took. It was just, I knew this is who I want to be with.
Okay. What about you?
I told my wife when the first time I seen her that we was going to get married. We was going bowling. We was going to the grocery store, going to the movies, getting married, and then we was going home. I told her. She said she don't remember, but I told her the first time I seen her.
Okay. So y'all know. Go ahead.
We are gathered here today.
Somewhere. Just best be clean and I'll talk to you when we get there.
Okay with y'all. Hey, that is the show. I thoroughly enjoyed you as I do each and every single week that I'm on with you guys. Y'all already know, find you, embrace you, most importantly, always, always love you. Until next week, people, Shop Talk right here on Spreaker.com.
Oh, I gotta go pick her up. I'm about to get beat up, y'all. I'm about to be real bad.